Fine. What we will be studying today is we'll be talking about basically how to generate reports and all. Okay, so we have talked about TestNG, right? Now, what we'll do is that we will talk about batch running, reporting, and all that stuff. I had told you that we have got the test cases like the login test, okay, and the password change test, the logout test, and all these test cases were there. So today we'll finish off TestNG. Okay, on the weekend you guys can practice, and from Monday we'll discuss the exercises. Okay, right. Now the first thing is how to run both these login tests and registration tests together. Fine, if I run this, you will see that. Hold on. This registration test will run successfully. Okay, right. I can run them individually by selecting them. Okay, now if I have to run them together, okay, right, then what we do is that we use a file known as testng.xml. Fine, hold on. This is testng.xml file. Okay, I will take this and I will put it under the project. Right, somebody was asking me about the location of POI API. I'll tell you by end of the class, Minal. Okay, just hold on. So this is testng.xml file. Right, if I open this file, right, and you know, this is an XML file. You can mention the test cases out here which you want to run in batch. Okay, I have got two test cases, right? You can mention any name over here. The first test is login test, the second test is registration test, and you need to mention the name of the classes over here with the package name. It is inside the package test cases dot reg test. This name should be the fully qualified and correct name, okay, otherwise it will not run. This name can be any name out here, but this name has to be fully qualified name. Okay, this is login test. So all the tests mentioned in this XML file will run from top to bottom, right, in a serial order. Okay, you right click on this XML file, you select the option run as testng suite. So what will happen is that all the tests over here will run serially. You see that? Okay, first login test and all its iterations are executed, then the registration test. Okay, this is how you batch run your test cases. Fine. Now, there is something known as like extent reports. Okay, right, those extent reports are actually something like this. I've shown you earlier as well, I guess. Have you guys seen the Maven module? Because extent reports, you need some Maven dependencies and all. Have you guys seen the Maven module? No. Please watch the Maven module as well. Okay. Look, to generate extent reports, what you need to do is that. Right. And the first thing is that I will include the extent jar file in my project. Okay. Right. So, hold on. This is the extent reports jar file. Okay, I will include it in my project. You need to include this jar file, right? I will paste this jar file in the project as well, so that when you download this project from my website, you can use this jar file. Okay, right. Now the next thing, for look, there are few predefined steps for generating extent reports. Okay, I will talk about them. Fine, let me do one thing. Let me start up Eclipse once more. Hold on just a minute. Right, just hold on. Just let it launch. I'll show you extent report generation. Fine. So you can put screenshots of the errors and all, everything in the reports. You can attach everything. You can put logs. It will give you pie chart description and all, everything, right? How to generate the reports. So just hold on. So this is the folder which I wanted to show you. Okay, right, and over here, this is the extent reports project which I have. Fine. Look, you need to get this file extent manager in your project and reports config.xml. okay, reports config.xml is a file which has got the configurations of the report, that what is like, what is the title of the reports, what is the name of the report. Okay, what is the headline of the report, the date format which will be used in the report, everything. So you have to copy this file and you need to paste it under the project in which you want to generate the reports. Report configuration.xml file. Fine. Okay, the next thing is that, right, I'll make a new package known as, say, admin. Fine. In this package, I'm going to copy the file extent manager.java. Okay, fine. And this file, what it does is that it's got a function known as get instance. Okay, right. This function will be called from the test case, right? For example, when I am starting the login test, okay, I'll write over here extent manager dot get instance. This get instance function is static in nature inside this function. It is static. So it can be directly called with the class name, right? Now there is an object of extent reports declared on the top. Okay, this is the internal class inside the jar file of extent reports jar file. This is the internal class. So what we do is that, right, if this object is null, then we initialize the object to the path where we need to generate the report. Okay, you need to keep the path over here where you need to generate the report. Okay, and that's it, right? Then you mention that you need to load the configurations, extend.load the configurations from the current project. System.getPropertyUser.dir will give you the path of the current project, and inside the current project there is a file known as reports config.xml. you need to load the configurations of the reports at that time, right, from there. Okay, and you can add some system info that Selenium version 2.46 is being used. Okay, environment is QA, UAT, production, whatever you want to add. You can add it out here. Okay, so right now we are using Selenium version 2.53, so you can use this. Okay, so you can create the object of extent reports pointed towards the path where the report is will be generated. Okay, so this function extent reports, get instance returns you the object of extend reports, right? Hold on, what I'll do is that I'll write over here. Extend, hold on. Extend reports rep equals to extend manager dot get instance. Okay, then you can write report dot start the test. Okay, you can write the test name as do login. Fine, and what you can do is that you can write over here, this will give you the object, this start test function, right, returns you the object of extend test class. Okay, you import this class, right? So from the report object you get the object of extend test. Now you can do the logging inside the test, right? You can write test dot log, right? Log status dot, there are various types of logs, error logs, failure, fatal, info, pass, skip, whatever you want to do. I'll write say info that starting the test okay, then test dot log, log status dot says if some error comes up, then you can write log status dot error, or if the test case is passing, or you can put info logs as well that validating something like title, right? Then suppose you want to mark the test case as pass, then you can write log status dot pass or fail, whatever you want to do, you can write test passed. So in between the test case you can put all these logs using the report, using the extend reports, right? And in the end it is very important, okay, that when you end the test cases, right, you hold on, there is a command which I am also forgetting. Look, I also don't remember everything because these are monotonous things. Yeah, you need to do write these two lines test dot end test and test dot flush, sorry, report dot end test and report dot flush. Without these two lines the reports will not be generated. Okay, now if I right click on my login test and say run as testng test, so you will see that there is some error coming up, right? So it says that no class definition found error. Okay, the reason is being that you need to add few more jar files for extend reports, okay, which you cannot directly add into the project. You need Maven over here, and that is why I told you that please watch the Maven video. Okay, you cannot just run it by including one jar file. You need Maven in this project to generate extend reports. All right, hold on, maybe I have those jars, because generally I run these through Maven. Just a minute. Yeah, maybe this is the one, free marker 2.2.3. hold on, because it practically when we work in the projects at all we use Maven, we don't include the jar files like these, right? Just a minute, let me run this now. Yeah, it's running. Yeah, you needed the other jar as well. So all the three tests were executed, okay, for the login test, and in the do login function I had generated the extend reports. So if I go to my report location, which we specified out here, that in D drive report folder you will have report.html which is out here, okay. If I open this, you have these reports. Let's say this is the do login function, starting test, validating title, test passed. Right? Okay, you can have the diagrammatic representation as well. Fine. So similarly, you can do the same thing inside the other tests as well. Say inside the password change test, I can write start the test, do password change, and suppose I will fail the password change test. Okay, test failed. Right. So, and in my look, you don't add all these lines in every test case when we work practically, but I'm just telling you, you don't get the instance of extant reports in every test case. But this is just an example in front of you. Okay, so this is the logout test. Right. And then in the registration test also, you can give the same thing. Okay, right, that is do register. Something like this. You can put the logs inside every test case. Okay. Right, so just a minute. That's what I'm telling you. You don't have to give these commands in each and every test, the first two lines and the last two lines. Okay, you can give the logging commands inside the test case. You don't have to give these two commands. I will tell you how you do it when we do the framework. This is just to make you understand that reports can be generated for every test. Okay. Now when I run it from testng.xml, okay, all the four tests will run. Oh, sorry, all the two tests will run. And if you look at your reports, right, these are the reports. And if you open it with Chrome, you see that the registration test executed three times. The first test which executed comes at the bottom. Do login executed first, then do password test which failed. Okay, it's coming out as an error. Logout, register, do register, and all that stuff. You can also see the diagrammatic representation over here. Okay, right. So this is how it works. Fine. Now if a test case is failing, for example a do password change test case is failing, you can also put the screenshot of the error in the log, in the reports. I'll show you how to do that. Right. And moreover guys, when we work practically, we generate the report based on the timestamp. Like these are some of the reports generated by me when I was running some tests. So based on the time and date, we generate the reports. Okay, we don't let the earlier reports, the current report override the earlier reports. Okay, fine. So now anyways, what I will do is that I'll tell you how to add a screenshot in the reports. Okay, for example, I have this this particular scene. Okay, I have this file. Okay, this is a image file. I need to put this file in the reports. Okay, how to take screenshot of the current page, that is done by Selenium. Okay, I'll teach you that in coming time. But if you have a JPG file, what Selenium will do is that Selenium will take the screenshot and store it on your hard drive. Okay, the extant reports will include the screenshot in them. Right, so this part I'm not telling you, I'm telling you this part, that if there is an image file, right, how to include the image file in your reports. Okay, so to do that, it's very easy. Okay, you can write over here test dot add screen capture. Sorry. and you can give the path of the file, that in my F drive you have got which file, img.png. Fine. So when you run it, and now you look at the reports, the test which is failing. Okay, it's not coming up. Hold on, just a minute. I'm making a mistake because all these codes are, you know, adding screenshot and all, these are monotonous type of lines, because in the framework also it's just written at one line. And hold on, test dot add screen capture. I'm doing a mistake, I'm sorry. Just a minute. Just a minute. I'll take it from this file. Test dot add screen capture. This is the line. Then. Okay. I'm sorry. I've done a mistake. Hold on. You have to write it like this. Test dot log status dot info. And then you have to write over here like test dot add screen capture f drive img dot png. I'm sorry. Right now when you run it, okay, you will see that it will come up. Look, all these reporting and screen capture commands, right, I also tend to forget them because it's at a centralized location in the framework. You don't write these commands every day. Okay, so you will see that, you see that the screen capture is there inside. If you click on it, it will get maximized, right? Okay, so this is how it works. Shakya, it is there in your account. I have uploaded all the code inside your account. When you log in into your account, you will see all the code and all everything. Okay. I have uploaded everything. Right. So this is how you generate the extent reports. I will put the other jar file as well, which is this one, free marker jar. Okay, we don't generate the extent reports jar file, the reports with directly adding jar files. We use Maven. Okay, these two jars, I have included them in your project. This project will be in your account. You can download it from there. Okay, right. So this is about TestNG. Okay, and this is what TestNG does. Right, I did not create a new folder over here day 13. I just used day 12 only, and I completed it. Now we will be discussing the exercises and we will be doing the project. Now guys, one thing I wanted to ask you, when we do a framework, there are various types of frameworks, data driven, hybrid, page object model, right? Which type of framework would you like to do in the class? Because I can just take one framework at one time. Okay, like there are various types of frameworks, like data driven is there, hybrid is there, page object model is there. Okay, which one do you prefer? I'll just take an opinion poll, because in 2-3 days I will be. Look, Parag, I cannot take cucumber because not everybody wants cucumber. Okay, right, you can watch the cucumber from the videos as well, right? So hybrid, because generally people in the class, they want hybrid or page object model or something. Minal, that's what I'm telling you. The cucumber is covered in the videos. Okay, you can have a look at the cucumber from the website. Like, it's very easy. It is not a difficult thing. Cucumber framework, it is very easy. If you go to the website, qtpselenium.com, right, What about others? Which type of framework would you like to do? If you go to the Selenium training section on the site. Okay. And if you look at Cucumber, hold on. Download the code again. I uploaded the code yesterday, Shakya. Download it again. Right. So out here on the website, training module 41 and 42 are on Cucumber. Have a look at them. Have a look at these videos. You'll come to know. It's over 6 hours, both of them. Yeah, that's a hybrid framework, Meenal, basically. What Meenal TDD plus keyword driven means you are using a hybrid framework. Okay. You must be having an Excel file having all the keywords and all, right? Okay, so that's a hybrid framework, right? So, what about others? Okay, XML file or Excel file. No, it's not that POM is used more days or POM is used lesser. Okay, it is from project to project. Okay, it varies from project to project, requirements to requirements. Okay, every framework is a good framework. It's not that page object model is better or BDD is better or hybrid is better. Okay, it depends on the project as well. Okay, you guys can decide, take your time and let me know in the next class, right? So now the exercises and all are left. Okay, so what I will do is that I will stop, sorry, stop here. I know it's early, but this is the weekend. Go and do the exercises on Monday, Tuesday. I will discuss the exercises, all of them, and do watch the Maven video. Okay, do watch the Maven video and do the exercises. From Monday, around 2 days, I'll be discussing the exercises which I had given you. And then from Wednesday, we'll start off with the framework. Okay, I'll tell you, when we do the frameworks, you will come to know what is the difference. Okay. Yeah, I'll upload the video, yes. Look, I cannot tell you like this. First, I will have to teach you one of the frameworks and then I will have to tell you. I cannot tell you in the beginning. If I teach you hybrid framework, okay, by the time we are over with the framework like 70 to 80%, then I will tell you that in this framework, the way we have done this thing in data driven, we do it like that. If I tell you in the beginning, you'll never be able to understand. Right. You can go for hybrid framework. It's a very good framework, right? Page object model and all, everything is explained in the videos, guys. It's not that I have not explained it or something. Okay. All the types of frameworks are explained. Only thing is that in one of the frameworks I take up in the class. Okay. I cannot cater to everyone, right? Because some people want hybrid, some data driven, some want page object model, right? Some want Cucumber. Okay, so that's why the videos are there, right? It's going to take me at least 11 to 12 hours to complete the framework. Okay, so the remaining classes will only be on the framework. Okay, so please be ready. Okay, please be ready with the exercises. Do practice, because things from this class onwards will not be very simple. Okay, right, it will be complicated. Right, you might not be able to understand few things. You have to be ready for that. All right. So I will be uploading the video for sure. All right. So from Monday, I will discuss the exercises, do them, watch the Maven video, and from Wednesday, we'll be starting off with the framework.